What's happening?
It's from next door. The Lespinets. Oh, come on, Dubourg.
Listen to that.
Stir yourself. Be a man.
Madame Lespinet. Are you all right? It's me, Dubourg.
Of course she's not all right. Front door's open. Come on. You hear that?
We should think about this. Perhaps send for a gendarme.
Oh, it's locked. Come on, Dubourg, put your shoulder to it. It's like a whirlwind passed through here. Furniture smashed to bits. Look, those sacks. Is that gold?
A robbery. But the gold's still here. Wait. What's that? Mademoiselle Lespinet? Can you hear it?
What?
That. Dripping down into the fireplace.
Oh, saints preserve us.
Blood. And hair. Blood and hair.
Inspector Lestrade.
You? Again? How on earth did you find me?
Simple enough. There are three public houses in the proximity of your lodgings, and you weren't in the other two.
Can you explain exactly what it is you find so hard to understand about the word no?
I understand the word well enough. I just don't see why you are so fond of saying it. Do you want another pint of beer?
I don't want to drink with you.
That wasn't the question. One drink, a few more minutes of your time, and then I'll give up if I have to.
You see, Miss Coleman...
Oh, call me Lucy.
As I said to you yesterday, Miss Coleman, although my name is inextricably linked with that of Sherlock Holmes, it's not a connection I want to dwell on.
I just don't see why you say that.
What you see or don't see, I don't really care. I've drunk more than enough. I'm going home now.
Sherlock Holmes by those who know him. Oh. This article is going to get written whether you help me or not.
Holmes, Holmes. Always Holmes, always him. What about the others?
The others?
Well, didn't you realise? He isn't the only noteworthy detective in the world. Oh, damn keys. Now, what is it?
He has rivals. Let me help.
Some of them fully his equal or better.
You know of these people?
I work with them.
To be truthful, Inspector, I'm a novice on trial, and the article on Holmes, most of it's being written by senior staff. You see, I'm just interviewing...
Just interviewing the minor figures. Yes, yeah, oh yes, yes, I do see.
That's not what I meant at all. No, sorry. But a story about one of Holmes's rivals, that could be my first truly original piece. Perhaps you remember what it's like, being a beginner?
Better than you think. You are one of the most persistent, incorrigible and tactless people I've ever encountered. I don't trust you an inch.
I had hoped. You're sending me away then. Damn.
On the contrary, you'd better come in. Kitchen to the left. Put the kettle on, Miss Coleman, while I gather my thoughts. They talk of Holmes as pioneer, but you know who he learned many of his tricks from.
Tell me.
I was in Paris after visiting the French branch of the family. This was many years ago, before I joined the force. I had different ambitions then, ambitions like yours, as a matter of fact, Miss Coleman. First, I needed somewhere to stay. I was told that the library was the place to go, so I did. I signed in at the register and went to examine their notice board.
Ah, lodgings to rent. Just the thing.
But this one was too expensive, and that one in Montparnasse. smacked a little too much of business. Then I spotted another card concealed behind the others.
33 Rue de Neuve, Faubourg Saint-Germain.
Slightly bohemian area, but a reasonable price, I thought.
Thoughtful gentleman required to share a set of rooms.
Thoughtful? Was that me? I decided to give it some thought and wandered into the library. Oh, it was the most beautiful place. A treasure chest of literature. I must have been there for quite some time, as I had completely forgotten about the errand that had brought me there. On realising that the library was about to close, I hurried back to the notice board. Standing beside it was a restless-looking young man, dark, glittering eyes, pale face. Had I seen him earlier? Then something astonishing happened. He gave me a crooked smile and extended his hand.
Mr. Lestrade, I think on balance, residence at number 33 would suit you very well. I welcome you as my tenant. And to answer your earlier question to yourself, yes, you are a thoughtful man. Auguste Dupin, at your service. Good evening to you.
Monsieur Dupin, I'm at a loss. You read my mind. You even know who I am without the two of us ever having met.
These things are sometimes easier than they look. The card bearing my address I slightly hid under other cards on the notice board. I wanted someone with sufficient powers of observation to find it. I asked for a thoughtful man, and when you read those words, your face certainly filled with thought. I agree with you, by the way, in your assessment of Montaigne. I revere him myself.
Well, he is a prince amongst essayists. This is impossible.
Watch yourself! Oh,
careful! I don't want to lose my first tenant before they put down a deposit. On the lower floor of the library, you glanced at a volume of La Rochefoucauld, blew the dust off it, evidently with approval. How did I know it was La Rochefoucauld? I didn't, until I went and looked at the volume in question. You ascended to the upper gallery. You nodded in pleasure. You ran your hand across one particular row of books. The selection of books lay in the late middle M's. I am familiar enough with the library to know the alphabetical position of the books at a glance. A man who appreciates the maxims of La Rochefoucauld will esteem the essays of Montaigne still higher.
Astonishing.
You aspire to be a writer yourself. Of course. You need refreshment. Here's a little place I sometimes visit. Off to you.
Here you are, gentlemen.
Ah, try this, Lestrade. Absinthe, a distillation of wormwood.
Remarkable stuff.
A very high alcohol content, that's true. Addictive in the extreme, so some say. Deleterious to the moral, so others claim, and liable to provoke insanity. An irresistible set of recommendations.
You said I aspired to be a writer.
Yes, as you were leaving the library, you paused before the painting of Racine. He is staring into the distance, right hand poised upon his chin. I saw your right hand steal to an identical position upon your chin. What would it be like to be possessed of the literary powers of Racine?
Yes, although it is only journalism I aspire to. Amazing.
Really no more amazing than seeing a dog gazing in a butcher's window and deducing its state of mind.
But you knew my name, Dupin. How on earth did you know my name?
Well, you signed the register. An utterly routine action, forgotten as soon as executed. To discover your name, all I had to do was, well, to go and look in the register. How interesting. That is the third gendarme I've seen in the last few minutes. Let us follow. That carriage. You know the name Grandjean? No, the head of the Paris police. That was his carriage. Let us hurry. The time, please.
Just past 9 o'clock.
We should definitely hurry.
What are we hurrying towards?
By the scene of the murder.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.